Hi friends, how are you? Many of my clients and my friends, they are asking similar type of questions. What will happen? How long this lockdown will continue? What will happen to our jobs? What will happen to our salaries? What will happen to our businesses? So many questions. Friends, I don't have direct answer to these. Nobody has, I think. But point is that what are we doing now? Many of my clients, those who were really wasting time for last 10 days, 15 days, just sitting idle and cribbing and getting into depression and always worrying, they are doing now much productive work that what can be done in this period. And some are coming with unimaginable things. Even in my own factory, they have, you know, when I encouraged my people, they are coming with such great ideas. What they can do even towards this corona, pandemic, and they are creating some medical accessories and, to help it out. So we can do a lot. We can do future plannings. We can do customer reviews. We can make connections with the people. We can review our past reports. We can do some R&D work. Lot of things actually. I know many of my clients have started working on it. You know, I'm really coaching them. So what are we doing today? Because it says whatever we are today because of the past, whatever we did in past, and what I'm going to have in future depends on what I am doing today. So friends, rather than sitting and wasting time and getting into depression and keep worrying and thinking about it, what is going to happen, let's take charge. And one thing I can assure you, that we all will bounce back if we are courageous enough, if we don't lose hope, if we are really still striving forward. One life story, real life story, amazing story she has. You know, there was a movie on her life also in Marathi. So she was born in a very poor family where the girls were not sent to school. Her name was also kept Chindi. Chindi means, scrap, not of any use. And she was not sent to school. She used to study, hiding herself. But at the age of 10, she was married. And by the age of 20, she had already 3 children and she was pregnant with 4th. Her husband would hit her because it was a belief that the girls or ladies should be, bitten up after every, 3 days so that they stay in their place. And after, when she was pregnant, so somewhere she used to protest against the, forest department for their rights. So that guy who was involved in that, he really put that blame and he came and told her to her husband that she's pregnant, not through you, but from, she's pregnant with my child. And her husband chucked her out of the house in that condition. And she went to she was thrown in the cow shed and where she delivered a baby girl. And the cows, how they protected her. And she was so moved. She says, if they can protect, I can also protect life. She started taking care of that girl child. And even she went to cremation ground. She stayed there because she thought that that's a place where she can be protected as a female. She was just 20 years old. And she would wear the clothes which were, thrown in the cremation ground or donated in the cremation ground. She started and ultimately one day came when she decided to commit suicide. But when she went, she met a beggar who was begging to eat or drink something. When she fed him. And then she realized if she could do that, she can do better things. Why to die? And ultimately, she started taking care of other children. She would sing in the trains and she would beg for, food and all. She will feed the children. And today, that lady is mother of 2,000 children. Even she adopted her husband when he came for the shelter. She said, I can't be your wife, but I can be your mother because I have so many children. And all the children have done excellent. They are advocates, they are doctors, and they are doing great. And how they all really consider her own mother. And she's been blessed with 500 awards. She's been traveled to 14 countries. What a life can do. So why can't you? So friends, don't be discouraged. Don't be hopeless.